biodiversity and conservation. This chapter is very important as well as very easy to understand, and you can score marks very easily. This chapter will not only give you a marks, but also it will make your moral values more and more strong, okay? And you will be aware about the environment, how to save it, how to protect the biodiversity, etc. Okay, so let's move on. First of all, you should understand the term biodiversity. What is biodiversity? So, if an alien visit our planet Earth, he would be really amazed by looking at the enormous diversity of the life. So really, it will fascinate us when we find the fight between the two dogs, when we listen the bird singing, peacock dancing, we get really amazed as well as astonished. Really, this is very, very, very great diversity. Biodiversity, right? Biodiversity is basically the totality of genes, species and ecosystem. Genetic diversity, it includes genetic diversity, species diversity, ecological diversity. Okay, biodiversity is basically discovered by Edward Wilson. Okay, biodiversity not only occurs in the species level, but also in the macromolecular level, such as bacteria, right? It occurs even at the micromolecular level. Okay, so it is basically a combined diversity. It's the sum of total kinds of life forms, right? Okay, let's move. Biodiversity. The term biodiversity refers to the totality of genes, species and ecosystem of a region. It is basically the totality of genes, species and ecosystem. Genes means genetic variability, species means diversity at the species level, and ecosystem means habitats, okay? Species, okay. Very simple. These are the two more definitions which are very easy. You can read it. Okay. So we know that Homo sapiens are the species, right? So humans are the part of a single species. So when we take about the number, there are more than 7 billion humans belonging to the same species, Homo sapiens. Okay, when we talk about the human, which is single human, when we talk about the number 7 billion humans, more than 7 billion humans are present, which belong to the same species, right? Okay. Let's move. Types of biodiversity discovered by Edward Wilson. Edward Wilson basically described the types of biodiversity. We'll understand. Genetic diversity, where the diversity occurs at the genetic level, species diversity, diversity at the species level, ecological diversity, diversity at the ecosystem level. These are the three types of diversity which is given by Edward Wilson. Okay, let's move to the first one is genetic diversity. The genetic variability, variety of alleles and genotypes found within the species is called as genetic diversity. Okay. Single species might show high diversity at the genetic level over its distributional range. Okay, here you talk about the single species. Let us try to understand the genetic diversity. Okay, when you talk about the single species, let us take an example of our body skin pigment, that is color of our skin. Color of our skin is more expressed near the place where there is a very high temperature, or else we can say where the sun is garish, where there is a garish sun. Okay, countries like Africa, we have high intensity of radiation, sun radiation. So to protect our skin from the highly concentrated UV radiations, our skin color becomes black. So this is really natural. Due to protect our skin from the UV radiations, our skin becomes black in color. So this is really natural. So you should never discriminate people on the basis of their color, right? Okay, very simple. So this is what it means. Single species might show high diversity. What I mean means countries like Africa, you might see the dark people because they have the garish sun. intensity of the sun is very high, radiations are very high. So to protect our skin from these radiations, the skin becomes black. Whereas countries like America, we find more white people. Whereas India have different, every color, right, mix. Okay, this is what happens. So it is color discrimination is really, really very bad. So this is really very natural. Okay, let's move. Medicinal plant Raw Ulfia Omitoria of Himalayan range produces active chemical respirin shows genetic variation. So basically the medicinal plant called as Raw Ulfia Omitoria, which is find in Himalayan range, it will mainly produce the chemical respirin. It will show the genetic variability, means it will show variety of alleles and genotypes. Basically it will have the same genes and the same species, but they are change in structure, color, taste, different varieties, right? Okay, so it is producing the chemical respirin, so it is showing one type of a genetic variations. Next one. India has more than 50,000 strains of rice. So you will be surprised to know that rice have 50,000 different strains. Okay, 1,000 varieties of mango. If you are in India, you will be loved with different types of mango. We have found out varieties of mango. We taste variety of mango. So what I said now, they have same genes and same species, but they are different in taste, right? We find different tasted mangoes, okay? Then, in human beings, there are races like African, Mongoloid, etc., right? Then, in Indian ox, the Indian ox has several breeds like Hallikar, Sindhi, etc. This is really very simple. Second important diversity is species diversity. Here, variety of different species in a given area is called as species diversity. Different species of a single animal like frog. Okay. Species diversity. What is species diversity? We get different species. We get different species in a given area. Okay, this is called as species diversity. Let us take example. Okay, let us try to draw the Indian map. This is an Indian map. Okay, small part. So we find here, this is western part and this is eastern part. Okay, this is western and this is eastern. We find greater amphibian species. We find here greater amphibian species in the western Ghats as compared to the eastern Ghats. Eastern Ghats have very less, but whereas western Ghats have lots of amphibian species diversity. Okay, this is what the species diversity is. Think you all have the excitement of knowing how many species of plants and animals are there on earth, and especially how many in India. So let us understand. According to IUCN, what is IUCN? International Union for Conservation of Nature and Natural Resources. So it is a basically international union where they associate for conservation of nature as well as for natural resources, which is opened in 2004. Okay, let's move. According to IUCN, 1.5 millions of plants and animals are there in our biosphere. Really, you will be surprised to know that there are 1.5 million plants that have discovered and described. Okay, more species have been discovered basically in the temperate regions as compared to the tropical regions. Okay, next one. Robot May places global species diversity at about 7 million. According to the estimation made by the ecologist Robot May, global species diversity is about 7 million. Diversity in global species is 7 million. Okay, next one. More than 70% of all the species are recorded are animals. All plants constitute about 22%. Basically, 70% are animals and 22% are plants. Okay, animals are 70%, 22% are plants. Okay. Among animals, insects constitute 70%. Okay, we know that 70% are animals and 22% are plants. If we consider that 100% animals among 100% animals, 70% are only insects, right? 70%, it is really huge. Insects are so many, mosquitoes, many, right? Next move. India has only 2.4% of the world's land area. Its share of global species diversity is impressive 8.1%. Among the world's land area, India is only about 2.4%, okay? And 8.1% among 2.4%, 8.1% is global species diversity. Okay, very simple. Then, India is considered one of the mega diversity countries of the world. Due to the richness of the species, genes, ecosystem, India is the mega diversity country of the world.